Hey guys, it's Vishal here, and today I am going to show you how you can solve overheating problem in your Android phone. So today I am using LETV LE1S, and you can use these methods in any Android phone. So without getting further ado, let's get started. So I came today with three methods. The first one will be for those who are not having rooted Android phone, and the second one will be for those who are having rooted Android phone, and the third one will be for those who are having both rooted and exposed framework flashed Android phone. So the first method is for those who are not having rooted Android phone. So basically people think that by downloading battery saver app and then downloading 360 security, those apps will help you to save your battery and even the overheating problem will be solved. But literally those apps will not work. And I have seen many times people saying that I'm using 360 security for saving my battery and blah blah. That will never work. Just uninstall those apps if you are using now. Why? Because in spite of saving battery, those apps will run in the background and it will drain your battery. And even sometimes it leads to overheating issues. So for solving overheating issues in your without rooted Android phone, just go to phone settings. And here go to application manager and here disable all those apps which you are not using. So once you will open an app, it will ask you two options, whether to disable or to force stop. Just disable it, click OK. And for some apps it will ask you to replace the app to its factory version. Just click OK and the updates will be installed and the app will be disabled. And here like this you can disable many apps which you are not using. So like this, once you will disable the apps, it will free up some of your RAM and it will let you to make your phone boosted up, and which means you can the phone speed will be increased somewhat and the overheating issues will also be solved. I am not telling that it will be solved 100%, but it will be solved at least 50%. And now if your phone is having permission settings in your phone setting app, then just go to there and you will be finding here auto launch. What you have to do is just disable all these apps and only enable those apps which you want to run in the background. Suppose I want to run WhatsApp so that whenever I will connect my net, the messages will come automatically, and even the Black Music Player and Nova Launcher. So this is the other option, and just go back. And if your phone is having phone manager, so this app comes in LETV phones, so I'm having LETV phone, so I'm showing it. So go to power saving management and here select two options, ultra long standby during sleep and lock screen cleanup. So here you will find apps protection. So basically I am not allowing these apps to close in the background. These apps, it will not close even if you lock the screen, and the apps which are enabled here will be closed automatically after some time when I will lock my screen. So these are the 3-4 simple methods which you can use in without rooted Android phone to solve your overheating issues. So the second method is rooted method. And for rooted method you need two apps, one is Kernel Auditor and the other one is Greenify. So I have given the two link in the description, you can download it from there. So once you will open Kernel Auditor, it will ask you to grant root permission for the first time. Just grant it. And here go to CPU settings. And it will be like this, it will be not enabled in apply on boot. Then what you have to do is go to CPU governor and select power save here. And once you will select power save, just click on apply on boot and reboot your phone. And after rebooting, it's my 100% guarantee guys that your 80% overheating issues will be solved. And by using power save mode, your performance will be decreased somewhat, but it will help you to increase your battery life, and also it will help you to decrease the overheating issues. And here you can see battery. It will show you your battery percentages, means how much battery is remaining and your battery capacity. and here you can see thermal. So thermal is basically for those people who are having heat issues in their phone. Just enable it and reboot your phone. It will also help you to control heating issues in your phone. So this is it for this, guys, and the other app is called a Greenify app. Open Greenify app. Once you will open Greenify app, it will ask you to grant root permission. Grant the root permission and hit the plus icon. And this is the paid version of Greenify app. The link is in the description. You can download it from there. And then all these green red apps are system apps. So I have given in the description which apps are good to hibernate, so you can use my description and disable those apps. By disabling the system apps to run in the background, it will let you to save a lot of battery, and also the heat issues will be solved. So just select this and hit the plus tick icon and insist it, and once you will click this icon, the apps will be hibernated and it will not run in the background. So this is it for this rooted method. The third method is for those who are having both exposed framework and root in their phone. So what we have to do is just install the Greenify app and go to exposed installer and then go to module section, then enable the Greenify module here and reboot your phone. After rebooting, go to Greenify app. Here go to settings, and here you can see that the working mode is root plus boost, which means it is an exposed module. Then go to exposed framebridge features, and here you can see deep hibernation. Just enable that so that even if the apps are hibernated and the other apps are trying to open it, that app will not open. So the same things you have to do, which I have shown you in the rooted method for Greenify, and you can see the description which are the system apps which will not affect your phone once you will hibernate it. So this is it for this video, guys. If you like this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe my channel.